Well, we have Mr. Kesavan of the Congress Party, Congress spokesperson, and Nirmala Sitaraman of the BJP and political editor of The Caravan, Hartosh Singh Bal. Thank you very much. Mr. Kesavan, can you tell us what is the one unique quality which Mr. Pawan Kumar Bansal has, besides his name having appeared in the context of Railgate and his being sacked unceremoniously by your party recently?
Arnab, first let's not delve into this realm of speculation. The seats have not been announced. All of us.
He came through the back gate to Sonia Gandhi's house to avoid the cameras because he was personally lobbying with Sonia Gandhi. Your party leaders have gone and said there is absolutely nothing wrong with him. There is no direct evidence implicating him. Even Narendra Modi, there is no direct evidence at all. He's been given a clean sheet by the SIT and the court, but still you claim that his government abetted what happened in 2002. You can't claim the CBI clean sheet to Bansal as the gospel truth. So my question is simple. You can pretend not to understand it, but I know you do. You're a smart man, Mr. Kesavan. I know you understand the question.
My answer is equally simple with respect to Narendra Modi ji.
Yes.
Basically, appeals are still pending.
No, my question
in higher
is about
court.
Pawan
so
Kumar Bansal.
That for the time being.
Question
come
is right
to,
now about
come
Pawan
back to
Kumar
Mr.
Bansal.
Pawan Bansal. I'm coming back to Pawan Kumar Bansal.
What is his unique quality?
No, you since you brought in Modi, I chipped in there. Let me come back to Bansal. There is no unique quality here. You see what happened here when there was an allegation.
Right.
He very clearly resigned on moral grounds before anything was substantiated.
Okay.
Please let me complete. Then now he was interrogated. Then this CBI
no,
says
under,
he is not.
Even, under whose
no
term did the scam unfold? Who was Railway
minute,
Minister when the scam happened?
Give me one happened? Minute. Let me tell you, Arnab, you are living in such vitiated times and such vicious atmosphere and milieu. Take people flaunt falsely proximity towards people impersonate people.
Okay.
For personal.
So Pawan Bansal didn't know that his nephew was a scamster.
Baseless allegation. No, let me. No, no.
His nephew didn't.
No, no, no.
He didn't know
I want to make. I want to make one point.
Nephew could have been a scamster.
No, no. No, no, Arnab, exactly, I want to address that.
So the nephew, what was the qualification of the nephew
this.
To be doing
you know
all
what
this?
What happened in 1971? No, no, you heard, no, no, let me answer this with an example. In 1971, you heard of the Nagarwala scam, where somebody impersonated the Prime Minister from the Prime and said that they need money from the State
no,
Bank.
No, but why is it?
No,
it's a coincidence,
the
therefore,
when
one second.
Went back to the Prime Minister's office. No, 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 it's not. No, it's not a coincidence, Arnab. Let me complete. When you talk about somebody impersonating a prime minister and, falsely taking money, why can't this person, falsely, claim proximity?
Who was he impersonating? You
were
saying, he was putting on a disguise and pretending to be somebody else. So who was the nephew pretending to be? Who was he impersonating?
Not at all. I'm saying he's falsely flaunting his proximity. No, no.
Falsely flaunting his proximity to Vijay Singla.
The minister is involved.
No, no. Vijay Singla was using his clout as the nephew
exactly.
of someone who was then a serving railway minister. So the fact is that Singla drew his clout from Bansal being in power. Understand that. It's simple. Why don't you pretend? The fact remains that Singla in his interrogation with the CBI.
Allow me to complete.
Singla. Singla in his interrogation with the CBI says that meetings between him and Mahesh Kumar, who is the person who paid the bribe, were held in the railway minister's residence. So two things are proved. He draws his influence by being close, by being nephew of Bansal. Bansal is in power. The meetings between the person, him and the person who pays the bribe happen in Bansal's residence. Right? Is this all wrong? But Bansal doesn't know.
No, then why did the CBI didn't charge sheet him?
No, the
you
court
then
says.
Ask the question to the CBI.
Did
the why court, didn't charge sheet him?
No, no. So question is, would he have been able to have clout or influence if Bansal had not been the railway minister? Come on, answer the question.
No, no, but that doesn't mean that. But it's very unfair to say that he was, hand in glove with everything.
No,
that
no.
Mr.
Who handles the appointments? Who handles the appointments of the chairperson of the board and the members of the railway board and the general managers of railways? Are they not directly handled by the railway minister? Are they not directly handled by the railway minister?
See, when the CBI would have taken cognizance of all you're saying, taken a considered opinion, when they had said he is not, there is no evidence to prove that he is guilty.
Bansal,
why don't we respect that judgment of the CBI? Why are you questioning the judgment of the CBI?
The question here tonight is a question very simple. The question is of propriety, and after this I'm getting the others in. The question is, Pawan Kumar Bansal says after the scam broke, and I quote, though a close relative, he or any relative of mine does not and cannot meddle in my official functions or influence my decisions. Did he or did he not say that? If he said that, that, how does he now explain what his nephew was doing so frequently in the Railway Bhavan and his residence while taking bribes and giving bribes? How is it happening? Does he not end up contradicting himself? Which side are we supposed to believe?
Arnab,
come on, please.
Mr.
Kesavan,
Mr. Pawan
Bansal
is a senior, senior politician. He doesn't... let me complete. Arnab, Mr. Pawan Bansal doesn't hold the brief for the daily activities of Mr. Singla.
Oh,
so let us not make him accountable for whatever Mr. Singla does.
So you'll give him a ticket. You don't care. This is new age politics. You give him a ticket. You reward
him.
That
is not decided yet. The Central Election Committee.
So what?
No, since all of you are raising this issue, it's in the media. Everybody is going to look at all these facts. The considered opinion will be taken by the elders at the Central Election Committee, upholding
elders,
the highest
come
standard
on, don't
of
shoot over the elders. I thought the young brigade is taken over the Congress party.
We will.
I thought the young brigade has taken over the Congress party. Nirmala Sitharaman, your first rebuttal here. Or are you not going to say anything because you are on the weak spot on Yediyurappa?
No, I think, Arnab, much before you even go back to your pet peeve on Yediyurappa, on which I have my own differences, allow me to say a few words on Congress spokesperson's statements which are being made here. I think we are speaking with spokespersons. This offhandish, laid back, just throw allegations business should be taken a bit seriously. What was the first line? There are appeals in the court about Mr. Modi ji, although of course he didn't start with Mr. Modi ji's name. He refers to your referring to it and therefore thought it fit to talk about it. What was the appeal? Where is the appeal? On whom is the appeal? If there are people charge sheeted, courts are handling them and there may be appeals. And in none of that, the Chief Minister of Gujarat's name is there. And therefore, to spread malice and to spread accusations which don't exist. I'm sorry, I thought we're dealing with an official spokesperson. This kind of spreading of not...
He wants to rebut you, Nirmala Sitharaman. He wants to clarify.
You know, well-viewed channel may have to be checked.
He wants to clarify.
Second, when it comes to talking about Pawan Kumar Bansal, what are the kind of kid glowish arguments that we're hearing? Impersonations. People hang around. Minister doesn't know who hangs around next and therefore doesn't know who are the people who are going to be working for the promotion of people who may be paying something. I'm sorry, again, a very offhandish comment. Is this the Congress party's viewpoint? I'm sorry. Let's be clear that this debate in your channel is on substantive party positions on these issues. If there's going to be a light-hearted banter, I'm sorry, BJP is not engaging in this.
Nirmala Sitharaman, 2 points. Nirmala Sitharaman, 2 points. One sec. First of all, he wants to clarify. Okay, now listen, you make a quick clarification, okay? But before that, Nirmala Sitharaman, wasn't it Anant Kumar who said about Yediyurappa? And you know, he said pet peeve. It's not my pet peeve. It's one of my favorite subjects when discussing the issue of corruption, because I can't think of anyone more brazen than in this case, you know, giving a ticket and just because you need to do politics with him. It's not a pet peeve.
Absolutely not.
It's a favorite subject.
And that is why I insist it's your pet peeve.
You can call it a favorite subject for anyone discussing corruption today and the brazenness of dealing with people.
Yes, absolutely. Your favorite subject, and I'll answer it also.
No, everybody's. It would be yours also. Why was Sri Ramalu denied a ticket? Who was questioning it on issues of perception? Come on. You know, you also know that these issues are...
See, the argument gets justified.
No. So, in you say, you know, Anant Kumar says merely leveling charges against Yediyurappa cannot be reason enough for giving him a ticket. He's a well-known leader from the state. Now, let me replace Yediyurappa with Pawan Kumar Bansal, okay? And the same argument can be made by any Congress leader. Merely leveling charges against Pawan Kumar Bansal cannot be reason enough for giving him a ticket. He's a well-known leader from the state. So, you know, you both say the same thing.
Can I answer?
Yes.
No, please. Arnab, get over this, you know, trying to bring in a level playing field.
There is a level playing field.
You have to talk of Congress, you have to talk of BJP. Get over that.
You provided the level playing field.
Today. You're talking on Pawan Kumar Bansal's case. Oh, wait a minute, Arnab. I know you're a very popular anchor. You should allow your poor panelists also to be heard by your viewers.
Certainly.
They'd like to hear people like us who come and face a lot of questions from you. Not just questions.
It's
answers
okay.
Also should be heard. So allow me to answer, please.
Yeah, go ahead.
Allow me to answer. It may be an answer which you can take up again and bash me up. But I will come back to the
I have no intention of doing that.
Which are legitimate
please.
For today's topic.
Yeah.
No, please listen.
I'm listening.
The topic today is about Pawan Kumar Bansal. You've had Yediyurappa in your topic n number of times. You can have it in Cell's fourth
also. No, when we discuss Yediyurappa, we bring up Pawan Kumar Bansal.
I'm raising a question. Don't please interrupt me. I may give you an answer which you can use against me again. But allow me to finish the answer. The question here is, today the final decision is being taken about party leaders in the Congress, and we are talking, therefore, a choice which you have made to talk on Pawan Kumar Bansal and his nephew. If the nephew is only impersonation or whatever, impersonating there, didn't the minister know about it? And today, after having given escape route for the minister, because there has not been a charge sheet or an FIR, he can be accommodated. But from 2002, the cases about which, incidentally, the Congress spokesperson doesn't seem to have much of an information. He churns out the usual run-of-the-mill arguments, which have no foundation at all. I wish
every case.
The Congress spokesperson corrects himself and comes for a substantive debate rather than throw allegations
Hartosh Bal is mocking in this debate between the both of you.
I'm defending my party leaders.
Hartosh Bal is mocking. I'm going to let you, Keshu. I know you are dying to have a go there at the opposition, but 1 minute, please. Hartosh.
Not at all.
Hartosh, are both sides looking a little weak tonight? Both sides.
Not at all.
No, I'm asking
the question here.
You've not even asked me about my issues.
Let me speak, please. Neither party is willing to accept that there are principles of administrative accountability and public propriety involved in any public office. Now, Arnab, you and I and every reporter has tried to get into a minister's house in this country. Take the railway minister's house. You know, senior members of the railway board are coming in and out of the house, meeting the nephew, and the minister is not aware of this.
Yeah, surprising.
And I mean, what is his security doing? What is his staff doing? And if he's informed of it, what action has he taken? This is highly problematic. It is exactly the case in Gujarat where Narendra Modi, his police force is standing aside and letting minorities be murdered, and he's not aware of it. And he has no accountability. And these two parties applaud the action of an admiral who takes personal responsibility for failures down the line in the Navy, which connect to the Defense Ministry. And they find that admirable. This is the kind of country we are living in. This is the kind of situation we are facing today.
Hartosh Singhbal puts it back to both the parties. Nirmala Sitharaman raises her hand. I'm going to come to you on the other side, because if Pawan Kumar Bansal gets the ticket tomorrow after his entry through a back gate into 10 Janpath, remember this, Mr. Keshavan, remember this. Remember this. You will bury the one thing which you promised to resurrect. If Pawan Bansal or Ashok Chauhan or Kalmadi, any one of them, their relatives, any of them get a ticket tomorrow, you will be carrying out the burial of public perception. You will be saying to the people, Congress party thinks perception doesn't matter. Mr. Keshavan, your rebut on the other side. I'm going to come back to you. So in the last 10 minutes of the News Hour debate, I throw the question on perception once again. Perception, which mattered when the party took the high moral ground. December 19th, 2010, 83rd Congress plenary. I don't know if you were there, Mr. Kesavan. I see your hand go up. I'm coming straight to you. Sonia Gandhi says
there.
No, you understand what she says? There is no tolerance for corruption. We must confront it. She was talking about perception. We made ministers resign. Can BJP do it? Did she say, we will make the ministers resign, but quietly before the election, we'll bring them back? She should have said that, no? Why didn't she say that then?
Arnab, politics is all about perception. Before I come right to the topic, I would like to talk about 3 points. First thing to Nirmala Sitharamanji, she's a very senior spokesperson. But I think, kindly refrain from being condescending to other people. We don't need patrons here.
Condescending.
And by taking an aggressive posturing and being churlish and petulant on a show and making personal barbs won't help you. Kindly let me complete. Have the decency to let me complete. I didn't interrupt when you spoke. So by indulging in petulant, churlish barbs, you will neither help yourself nor your party. Point two, with respect to the Gujarat issue, Arnab, they conveniently forget that the Supreme Court had also asked the Ombudsman and the amicus curiae to submit a report. And that is the report which has been, you know, basically turned down by a lower court now, which is going to be appealed. So it is still pending. Let them get the facts straight. Third point I want to make about the ordinances before I come back to Pawan Bansal. Because
are we talking about ordinances or Pawan Bansal?
See, all of everybody...
What are you talking about? Are we talking about ordinances?
I'm coming back. I want to make a very, very pertinent point.
No, you have not addressed the issue at all. I asked you, Manish Tiwari said, in fact, Manish Tiwari himself is upset. Manish Tiwari, I am told, has made it very clear where he stands on these issues. Manish Tiwari is begging and appealing. Your information and broadcasting minister is appealing today to your party. And he said, you remember what he said when Shashi Tharoor resigned? Look at Shashi Tharoor, a glorious comeback for Shashi Tharoor. Did he not say when Shashi Tharoor resigned that they resigned on the basis of perception? So what happened then? No perception required in 2014.
Let me
definition
make one point
changed.
With respect to
Sonia Gandhi allow Kalmadi to be removed? Why did Sonia Gandhi authorize the sacking of Ashok Chavan? Why did Sonia Gandhi insist on the removal of A. Raja? Why did Sonia Gandhi, even to Shashi Tharoor, who she is known to support, why did she say that he should go? Because of perception, Mr. Kesavan.
I'm answering your question. Let me complete here.
No, you're not coming on the subject.
Not at all. We have upheld the highest probity by ensuring everybody resigns when there is an
and
allegation.
And bring them back before
there
the election.
There is going to be a charge
and bring them back before
then
the
a
election.
I'm coming back to you. No. Let me complete one point, Arnab. You asked me a question.
See, you're taking
you're
a long time a to come to the main
Mr.
point.
Pawan Kumar Bansal and Chavan. No. I'm coming back to the point. See, you take the case of Mr. Chavan. See what happened. Basically, you know, he was a former chief minister. When the CBI wanted to press charges, they had to get a legal sanction.
No, please don't tell me about Chavan. I know the Chavan issue better than you, Mr. Kesavan. The fact is that Mr. Chavan in the report was accused of a quid pro quo.
In Mr. Chavan's case, the CBI said they wanted to prosecute
was
but lacked legal sanction. But in Mr. Pawan Bansal's case, they very clearly said there is no charge sheet. There is no evidence
but,
to find
so
him guilty.
So what is Nirmala Sitharaman saying? We believe you. I'm sure your Congress party leaders think that Pawan Bansal had no idea. Pawan Bansal is a simple, innocent man. Pawan Bansal has no idea what is going on in his ministry. So what if his nephew comes in? So what if his house deals are being done? So what if his name, you know, he's using his clout? So what if the final authority rests with him? Pawan Bansal just did not know. Pawan Bansal, next time you'll argue, may not even know which portfolio he holds. Pawan Bansal may think he's the culture minister, not the railway minister.
Still in the realm of speculation.
Speculation?
Arnab, you should have this debate when Mr. Bansal has been given a ticket.
No, I don't know.
He's not given a ticket yet. Why this brouhaha?
No brouhaha. He entered Janpat to lobby today. He went to Sonia Gandhi's house to lobby today. Right or wrong? Tell me honestly.
A party worker can meet a Congress president.
That's right. So fine.
Hyperbole.
That's all right.
A party worker can meet a Congress president. He's been a former minister.
No, I'm not saying. You see, Pawan Bansal, the only question is that of perception. Nirmala Sitharaman hands went up. And by the way, let me repeat here, and I'm not saying this to provoke you. Nirmala Sitharaman, you have been accused tonight on the News Hour of being condescending, churlish and petulant by the Congress person, Mr. Kesavan. Your turn to respond to him.
First thing, I did not even take his name, but I will certainly have the, being a co-panelist, right to rebut, especially when he turned out wrong facts. And when he tried to recover by saying, no, you know the ombudsman, he's not an ombudsman, he's an amicus curiae. And that amicus curiae's report, all of us have debated a number of times, was a part of the SIT, and then it went over to the lower court. The lower court went to the closure of the case. The complainant has decided to go against the court's decision. All that is laid bare. But when you speak, therefore, speak of the specifics. Oh, there are lots of appeals, and therefore, you know, you never know when Mr. Modi is also going to go to the jail.
That's not what he said.
This kind of insinuating, generalized statements cannot be accommodated, is what I said earlier, and I'm now saying it again.
Please.
As a spokesperson, I only wanted to remind him that he go on facts rather than anything else. If he's feeling as though, you know, I've taken a personal barb at him, I'm sorry, I don't know what makes personal, I've not even uttered his name. Whereas he did now. Now that he's done it, I'm therefore saying, Congress party be clear as to what is it that they're conveying in these kind of messages. They do not want to clearly explain what is happening about their corrupt ministers on whom charges may or may not be framed eventually. Because we know the extent to which institutions are being misused. Ministers who are supposed to be facing questions are not even subjecting themselves. I'm glad you remind all of us about Burari meet, in which Mrs. Sonia Gandhi had spoken a lot about corruption. And in that very meet, the Prime Minister himself had said, I'm willing to come and face inquiry, face the, you know, JPC or PAC, which he unfortunately has not been done till today. Whereas I'd like to contrast here, and that probably even addresses Santosh Bals's point. Modi went through a 9-hour session with the CBI, especially the SIT appointed investigation. Therefore, none of us are running away from
Nirmala Sitaraman. I'm sorry, Nirmala Sitaraman. Hartosh will respond to that.
Not had that coming from
Nirmala Sitaraman. I'll respond to that. No, Nirmala Sitaraman. I've heard you there, but you know, I'll tell you. Nirmala Sitaraman. You know, please, Nirmala Sitaraman.
Yep.
Rajnath Singh.
Yep.
Okay. Rajnath Singh, Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi had a round of meeting. Okay. With Abhay Singh Chautala, younger son of INLD chief Om Prakash Chautala, over the weekend. There is talk you will embrace the INLD into the NDA. You don't care. You don't care. You don't care at all that the party leaders are convicted in the teachers' recruitment scam, that they are awaiting their petition, challenging their conviction from the Delhi High Court. So I'm not on my favorite subject of Yediyurappa, but look here, Chautala. What a wonderful alliance. Does perception matter for you? You're doing a tie-up with a party whose party chief is in jail over a conviction in a teacher's recruitment scam. Come on, Nirmala Sitaraman. We're only talking perception tonight. Not conviction, perception. On perception, you're weak. In fact, Chautala is convicted. Chautala is convicted. Bansal is not even convicted. He's not even an accused in the case. He's only a witness. So there you are.
That's right. I'm not engaging in a two meme. I agree, perceptions matter.
So Chautala,
I'm sure the party is seized of it. No, that's what I'm saying. The perceptions matter. The party is seized of it. Let's see what comes out of it.
You're being diplomatic.
And much before I close,
you're being
as
diplomatic.
The party spokesperson, I will remind you, RJD
diplomatic.
Lalu Prasad Yadav, who was in the jail, Congress has no inhibitions talking, and you have probably even questioned them. But when it comes to us,
no, I'm saying that
question will come much before anything.
I'm saying. One minute.
Can I just make one point?
No, Mr. Kesavan, I give the last word to Hartosh. I give. Okay, you want to rebut? 30 seconds to rebut. Yes, then Hartosh will have the last word.
No, one point. Arnab, talk about Kameshwar Baitas from JMM, who's been accused of 53 criminal cases and killing 17 jawans. They have inducted him in March in
what about
BJP.
Kalmadi?
Do I have an answer for that?
What about Kalmadi? You have an answer for Kalmadi? You are confused about Kalmadi.
Kalmadi has not been given a ticket.
What about Chawan
from the party?
Who garlanded Rahul Gandhi?
From the party.
Committee.
He has been suspended Sheena from the party. Dixit. You look at what Mr. Sitaraman actually said. What about the Reddy brothers? What did Sushma Swaraj do? Sushma Swaraj has raised the issue of Reddy brothers. Sushma Swaraj has raised the issue of Reddy brothers in the election committee. People are keeping mum. What did Sitaram actually say? It's a deadly cocktail of communalism and corruption when they talk about Kalyan Singh and Yediyurappa.
Don't worry.
They keep mum on Yediyurappa. They keep mum on Reddy brothers. They keep mum on, Kameshwar Baitas. Please give an answer.
Hartosh Singh Bal, will they get the ticket tomorrow? What do you think, Hartosh?
You listen to the answer for a minute, Mr.
I need to close this, Nirmala.
Please listen to this.
Nirmala.
Shukru committee report indicted Arnab, Sheela Dixit.
Arnab, if I may say what I have to say at this point,
the governor to Kerala.
Hartosh.
That is enough for you.
Hartosh, will Bansal get the ticket, your hunch?
If you... Well, I think if they keep paying attention, if the Congress is stupid enough, that means they have foregone the lessons of the last 3 years. They are in this dismal shape because they have not paid heed to public perception.
Exactly.
But they seem suicidal, so they might still do so.
You think
so? And I also want to point out something about what Ms. Nirmala Sitharaman said. 9 hours of kid glove questioning by SIT,
Nirmala.
Which is why Narendra Modi is not willing to face even 9 minutes of questioning by a skeptical journalist anywhere in the country.
Everyone's in line.
Not at all. He sat in the CA conclave.
No, we'd like to do an interview as well, Nirmala Sitharaman. Our application is pending.
Not.
1 second. You can
I'll
put in a word. Now, here you
he
are. Nirmala Sitharaman.
Conclave. Journalist questioned him.
No, we'd like an interview. Nirmala Sitharaman, we'd like an interview. Nirmala Sitharaman, Mr. Kesavan, and Hartosh Singh Bal, perception matters. We'll know tomorrow if Bansal gets the ticket. If Bansal doesn't get the ticket, that means Congress believes perception matters. If Bansal gets the ticket, then maybe perception is dead. We wait for tomorrow. And tomorrow's a big day. We'll know if Jaitley is contesting the elections. We'll know if Subramaniam Swamy gets a ticket. I mean, Nirmala Sitharaman has been... Your name has been doing the rounds for a big ticket on your party. I don't know. So tomorrow's the big day. BJP Lok Sabha tickets round 2. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for debate number 3 on the News Hour tonight.